Hello everyone. So today we are going to start a new chapter in SST, that is Towards Freedom. So first of all, we need to understand the meaning of the chapter. The topic, the heading is Towards Freedom. Towards means in the direction of. Okay, and freedom means the state of being free. Okay, the right to do whatever you want to do. To say whatever you want to say, to think the way you want to think, to express your views freely without anybody's interference. So this is called freedom. And the towards freedom means the steps taken in the direction of getting that freedom. We all know India got independence on 15th of August 1947. And it was not an easy freedom. Do you know, beta? Many leaders, they gave up their lives, they sacrificed their lives, they were tortured, they were hanged, they were starved to death, and they gave us freedom. Just for us, they had sacrificed their lives, which we do not understand, and we need to understand that. So in this chapter, we are going to understand how they took the initiative to fight against the wrong. Okay, so in this chapter we will cover few points like who came to India and why, then how did the farmers they become poor, what was first war of independence, the revolt of 1857 which is also known as the Sepoy Mutiny, then what happened after 1857, what were the factors responsible for the failure of this revolt, then social and religious reformers, then rise of nationalism and formation of Indian National Congress. So we'll cover all these topics in this chapter. So let us start this. As we know, India was always known as the golden bird, Sone ki chidiya. Bharat ko sab Sone ki chidiya shuru se kehte aaye hain. What was the reason for that? Why was it called a golden bird, Sone ki chidiya? Because India was known for its prosperity, riches and wealth. Right children, India has always been famous for spices, textiles, jewelry and pearls. And the people around the world, they had heard the stories of the prosperity of India. And they all wanted to come to India for some trade or business. So they kept on coming one by one. So who was the first one to come to India? The Arabs. They were among the first to come to India for trade. Then Portuguese, the Dutch, the French, and the British followed, and they all came to India just with one purpose, that was business, trade. But after coming to India, they didn't want to go back. When they saw the wealth and riches, prosperities of India, they wanted to get settled here. And it happened when the people from the world, different parts of the world, they kept on coming to India. There was a competition amongst themselves. What was the competition for? It was for the survival. Ek simple si baat hai, jab bhi do log aapas mein ladte hain, jo powerful hota hai, wo jeet jata hai, hai na? So all these Portuguese, Dutch, French, they all started their business, trade work here. But British emerged as the most powerful among them. And the British exploited all the sections of the society. They established one company known as East India Company, and what they did, the company bought goods at very cheap prices from India and sold them abroad at very high prices, and this resulted in huge profits for the company. Isse kya hua? Profit to East India Company ko hua, and it started becoming richer and richer day by day. And on the contrary, जो इंडिया के लोग थे, they started becoming poorer and poorer day by day. Slowly and gradually, the Britishers who had come to India just with the purpose of doing business, they established control over the whole of India and taking advantage of the lack of unity amongst the Indians. What was the reason? यदि हमारे घर में कोई गेस्ट आएगा बेटा, तो उसे हमारे बारे में सब कुछ नहीं पता ना, उसे कैसे पता? तब तक नहीं पता जब तक कोई और उनको हमारे फैमिली मेंबर नहीं बताएगा हमारे बारे में. सिमिलरली इट हैपन्ड विद आवर कंट्री ऑल्सो. इंग्लिश लोग हमारे देश में आए, द ब्रिटिश केम टू इंडिया, दे वर टोटली अननोन, दे डिडंट नो एनीथिंग अबाउट इंडिया, बट देयर वॉज डिसयूनिटी, द पीपल दे वर नॉट यूनाइटेड एंड फ्यू पीपल हु वर नॉट ऑनेस्ट एंड लॉयल टू देयर कंट्री, दे हेल्प दोज पीपल एंड दिस हेल्प देम इन कॉन्करिंग लार्ज पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड दे एस्टेब्लिश्ड देयर रूल. Is it clear now what happened? Once the British, they were firmly established in India, they started exploiting the farmers, traders, craftsmen, and the rulers of the local kingdoms. The people, they started becoming angry. They had some anger in themselves because now they were the owners of the places and they were made slaves. The farmers who were very much free to grow whatever they wanted, now they were not allowed to grow according to their wish. The farmers, they were made to pay very high taxes. Chahe natural calamities hoti, floods, droughts, kuch bhi aa jata, usme bhi they had to pay the taxes. Now in their own country, the farmers, the craftsmen, they all had become like slaves. Now, not only this, the British, they forced the farmers to grow indigo. You know what is indigo? Indigo is a plant जिससे हमें एक color मिलता है बहुत ही dark, उससे कपड़ों को dye किया जाता है. Okay? So, what happened then? The farmers, they were forced to grow only indigo and cotton. And these things, they were bought at very low rates and sold at very high rates in England. जो Britishers थे, वो लोग क्या करते थे? यहाँ से सामान लिया, इन लोगों से indigo वगैरह और कॉटन यहाँ पे फार्मर्स ने ग्रो किया, उसे बहुत ही कम रेट पर खरीदते थे और अपने देश में जाकर के हाई रेट्स पे बेच दिया करते थे और इंडिया जो था वो बिल्कुल पुअरर एंड पुअरर होता चला गया. मैनी पीपल, मैनी फार्मर्स, दे डाइड ड्यू टू स्टारवेशन. स्टारवेशन मीन्स भूख से मर गई. व्हाट वाज द रीज़न? क्योंकि उनको तो राइस, व्हीट कुछ ग्रो करने नहीं दिया उन लोगों ने, एंड दे कुडंट ग्रो द क्रॉप्स, दे हैड टू पे टैक्सेस, दे डिडंट हैव एनीथिंग टू ईट, दे died. And then cheaper, very cheap mill-made cloth was imported into India. और इंग्लैंड से बहुत ही घटिया किस्म का कपड़ा खरीद करके भारत में लाना शुरू कर दिया, जिससे जो इंडिया के अंदर हैंडलूम पूरी की पूरी इंडस्ट्री थी, it suffered a lot. Then lakhs of weavers, they became unemployed. They suffered the same. And what happened? They faced the same fate as the farmers. Now the British didn't allow the Indians to open mills and factories. पूरी तरह से भारत का होल चला गया ब्रिटिश के पास और कुछ भी काम इन लोगों को उन्होंने करने नहीं दिया. And then Indian rulers और जो princes थे छोटे छोटे राज्यों के, they became very unhappy with the British because their policies were wrong. They even passed a law according to which a ruler, if he dies and he doesn't have a male child, then upon his death, his kingdom would be taken over by the British. By using all these unjust and unfair means, the British, they wanted to expand their hold over India, and they had done that. They were successful in this. So, the dissatisfaction and anger of most Indians led them to revolt. So, these were the reasons. The people, they started thinking that now they have to take the steps towards freedom. They have to fight for their rights. They cannot survive like this because India is their country and Britishers, they had come just for trading purpose and now they have become the owner of the country. And their behavior towards Indians, it was very cruel. They tortured the people. They were humiliated everywhere. Unki bahut insult ki jati thi. And now British administrative laws, they ruined both the peasants and the landlords. Indian handicrafts totally collapsed. India became a marketplace for finished goods from England and poverty increased. So this discontent motivated the Indians to join the revolt in large numbers. So people in different parts of India, they had been protesting against their unfair policies. However, there was no unity in their protest. But it was only in 1857 that a major revolt broke out. It is also known as the First War of Independence, also called the Sepoy Mutiny. the Great Revolt of 1857. It was an important event in our struggle for freedom. The revolt was started by the Indian soldiers serving in the British Army in India. What was the reason for that? Actually, the British, they introduced a new rifle called the Enfield rifle. And a rumor spread that the grease which was used in the bullets, it was made from the fat of cows and pigs. And the soldiers, they had to bite off the greased, wrapped bullets before loading it into the rifles. This was against the religious sentiments of both. And Hindus and Muslims both refused to use those rifles and they revolted. Now what happened? The revolt started at Meerut and soon spread to different parts of the country. Now farmers, craftsmen and other sections of the society, they joined the revolt because everybody was angry. So soldiers declared the last Mughal emperor Bahadur Shah Jafar their leader. So revolt was led by Nana Sahib and Tantia Tope at Kanpur. Rani Lakshmibai, she led at Jhansi, and Begum Hazrat Mahal, she led at Awadh. Different parts mein there were different leaders. But what happened? British, they suppressed the first war of independence, and the people of India, they lost this war. Bahadur Shah Jafar, he was exiled. He spent the last 5 years of his life in Rangoon and he died in 1862. There were many factors who were responsible for the failure of this war. Number one, it didn't spread to all the parts of the India. Number two, Indian soldiers, they were not having sufficient money and good weapons because they were exploited by the British. Unke paas tha hi nahi sara saman, acche se weapons bhi nahi the, unke paas money bhi nahi thi. The revolt was not organized properly. On the other hand, the British soldiers, they were well equipped, they had modern weapons and they were very well organized. So after this revolt, many Indians, they were killed or they were put into the prison by the British. One thing happened after this war, that the rule of the East India Company, it came into an end in 1857. The administration of India was taken over by the government of England. Is it clear? Now, after this first war of independence, the people, they had understood the importance of freedom. Now, they were very well aware of that the purpose of the British was to keep them poor forever. They wanted them to keep as slaves forever. Now, what happened? The educated Indians, they introduced many social and religious reforms. Raja Ram Mohan Rai, Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, Debendranath Tagore, they all were very much educated people and they were active during this time. So they strongly protested against some social practices which were very bad, like Sati Pratha, killing female babies, child marriage, caste system. They were totally against all this and they started educating the people for the same, and they also encouraged the widow remarriage and education of women. They wanted that the women should also be educated. Now, since people now had understood the real intention of the British, they all now started becoming united. The people, they realized that the British people will never allow them to grow. So, this realization united the Indians. Slowly, the feeling of unity or nationalism, it grew stronger. अब उन लोगों में क्या हुआ, अपने देश के लिए क्या फीलिंग आने लग गई कि भारत जो है ये तो हमारा देश है, हमें इसको क्या करवाना है, फ्री करवाना है. और इससे क्या हुआ, राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म. द ग्रोइंग फीलिंग ऑफ नेशनलिज्म, इट रिजल्टेड इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस इन 1885. सो द इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस, इट इंस्पायर्ड ऑल द पीपल ऑफ द कंट्री to fight against the British. This Indian National Congress was formed by an Englishman whose name was Allan Octavian Hume, and its first meeting was held at Mumbai. It was attended by 72 delegates from all over India, and who was the president of this session? Vomesh Chandra Banerjee. The purpose of this meeting was to awaken the spirit of the unity among the Indians, and the Congress met every year in different cities. It became very strong. At the same time, it requested the government to introduce different policies to improve the living conditions of the people. Yes, one thing we all need to know that the Indian National Congress Party was not formed to demand independence from British rule. Actually, it was set up to bring together a group of educated individuals of India on a common platform so that they can put forth their views and they can raise voice against the wrong policies of the government. Indian National Congress, it became very popular, and because of its popularity, the British, they became very much worried. The spirit of unity among the Indians was awakened by the INC. And INC, it requested the British government to introduce reforms for the improvement of the living conditions of the people. And British didn't like that, so they passed various laws to suppress the growing popularity of the INC and the spirit of nationalism in Indians. They started playing the policies of divide and rule. Is it clear? That's all in this chapter. In next chapter, India Wins Freedom, we will learn about how the freedom fighters, they struggled and forced the British to leave India. That's all in this chapter. Okay, have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you.